I'm delighted to announce the publication of the fourth in the Covenant and Conversation series, the book of essays about Bamidbar, the book of Numbers, the fourth of the five Mosaic books. It's published by Magid Books, an imprint of Koran Publishers. And what makes Bamidbar so challenging is that it seems to be a difficult and depressing book, a strange jumble of laws and narratives, and the narratives themselves are almost universally depressing, a story of rebellions, complaints, and demoralizations. But actually, I discovered in writing the essays that Bamidbar is probably the most contemporary of all the books because it is speaking right to where we are now in the history of the world in the 21st century secular time, when we believed just a few years ago with the Arab Spring that there was going to be a new birth of freedom in so many countries in the Middle East, and we're seeing one after the other lapse into a kind of Hobbesian state of nature, the war of every man against every man, in which life is nasty, brutish, and short. Why is freedom so hard to achieve? And the book of Bamidbar is the answer, because it tells us that there are two parts of the journey of freedom. The part we read in the book of Exodus, the journey from negative liberty, the fact that we've emerged from slavery, nobody can tell us what to do. But that negative liberty doesn't generate a free society, because if you have a society in which everyone's free to do whatever they want, the result is anarchy and chaos. Bamidbar is therefore telling us about the difficult second stage of the journey to positive liberty. That is to say, it tells us what we need to create a free society, the laws and the stories that tell us where we went wrong in the past and how to avoid doing so in the future. Bamidbar is a book for our time, a book of law-governed liberty, which is the second part of what Nelson Mandela called the long walk to freedom. I hope you enjoy it. I enjoy writing it. And that is Bamidbar for today.